I was recently watching this Veritasium video where Derek asked people a question that to me seemed quite obvious. Rank the following from biggest to smallest: moons, planets, galaxies, stars, and the universe. And the answers shocked me.
Yeah, I'd say moon is probably
the smallest. I'd say stars are the smallest.
But the sun is a star.
I'd say planet might be the top of the line.
We are not astrology majors.
So I think we need to put into perspective just how big the universe really is. From the biggest planets and stars to the truly unbelievable size of supermassive black holes. Let's go for a journey. I'm sure I don't need to tell you that the sun is much bigger than the Earth. You've probably already seen comparison videos and pictures like this. When I hear that the sun is 110 times wider than the Earth, it's hard for me to truly understand what that scale looks like. So I figured, why don't I just show you? For our demonstration, one grain of rice represents a single planet Earth. Every human who ever was and likely ever will be is from this little grain of rice. It takes just 1300 Earths or grains of rice to fill Jupiter. It looks something like this. And I know what you're thinking. What about the sun? It would take 1.3 million Earths to completely fill the sun. Remember, each one of these grains of rice represents the entire Earth. Every human being who ever was and likely ever will be is from just one of these grains. Of all the mass in our solar system, every planet, asteroid, comet, moon, and of course the sun, 99.86% of that mass is in the sun. And nearly 90% of that tiny remaining sliver is taken up by Jupiter and Saturn. Our Earth's mass is nearly nothing on this scale. And I don't think you truly understand how little Mercury is. Mercury is actually really, really small, around 40% the size of Earth, just barely larger than our moon. You could fit all of Asia on Mercury. Okay, so what I'm holding here is a real scale model of the Earth and the Moon. If the Earth really were this size, the Moon would be just this big. My question for you is, if the Earth and Moon were really this big, how far apart do you think the Moon would be orbiting? Most people say something around this size, or maybe around like here, but it's actually much, much bigger. Okay, so we've got our scale model of the Earth and the Moon. Now let me show you just how far away the Moon really orbits from the Earth. You might think at this scale it might be something like this, but in reality it's actually all the way over here, 4.6 meters away from the Earth. In true to scale terms, this translates to around 300,000 miles. Now I know that size comparison just looks completely insane, but it's actually true. In fact, the distance between the Earth and the Moon is so big that you could fit every single planet from our solar system in the gap. Kind of makes you realize that the Apollo missions to the Moon were actually kind of impressive. Before we continue exploring the universe, I just want to thank Odoo for sponsoring this portion of the video. Put simply, Odoo is an all-in-one management software that helps entrepreneurs reach their business goals. They have a ton of applications for you to explore, but something I found interesting is they actually let you launch an e-commerce site without any of the hassle. They've even added AI functionality to help perfectly structure your online store. You can just pick what kind of website you want for your specific business and what your main objective is with the site. Then it's just a case of submitting your brand's logo or using one of their pre-made palettes, selecting specific pages and features that you need on your site, then just let it work its magic. The whole system and process is really intuitive and requires no coding knowledge. You can fully customize your website and get it ready to sell products in just a few minutes by simply adding the product, setting a price, and adding some images. The best part is your first Odoo application is completely free for life, including unlimited hosting and support. They even give you a custom domain completely for free for an entire year. This tells me as an entrepreneur that they are really backing their applications and putting their money where their mouth is. Once you have two or more applications, you can then move on to one of their affordable paid plans. So if you're an entrepreneur and this sounds exciting to you, just click the link at the top of the description to check out Odoo, and in doing so, you'll be supporting the channel. Now let's go see some truly massive stars. The Veritasium video that I showed you broadly talks about the size of stars as a whole, but there are lots of different kinds of stars, and their sizes can vary enormously. This is largely why many of the stars in our night sky look so different to us here on Earth. Like, why are these extremely bright stars so bright, when there are millions of extremely faint ones hidden from us? Of course, it's largely due to light pollution, but that's a different story. Let's start with our Sun. The Sun is known as a main sequence star. It's really stable and fuses mostly hydrogen into helium in its core. 90% of all stars in our universe are main sequence stars, and they can vary from red for the cooler ones to bright blue for the hotter ones. Smaller than our Sun, we find white dwarfs. These are the remnants of low mass stars that have shed off their outer layers. They are extremely dense and hot compared to the Sun, being about the same size as our Earth. They actually aren't fusing elements in their cores. Instead, they are just radiating light and heat as they cool down over time. Nearly all the stars in our universe will end its life as a white dwarf. Even smaller are the neutron stars. These are the remnants of massive stars left behind from supernova explosions. They are made nearly entirely of neutrons, making them extremely dense. While they are just the size of a regular city, they are 1.5 times more massive than our entire Sun. Then we move on to the supergiant stars. These are stars that are hundreds to even thousands of times larger than the Sun. Because they are so big, they rapidly use up their fuel supply and don't exist for very long before they die in a supernova. Betelgeuse is a famous example of a red supergiant. But what about the biggest stars in the universe? I'm of course talking about the hypergiant stars. If you go to Google right now and just type in what is the biggest star in the universe, it will show you UI Scuti, a star 909 times bigger than our Sun. But that is wrong. There is a star that's even larger, and it's honestly terrifying. Meet WOGG64, an unusual red hypergiant star in the Large Magellanic Cloud. It is 1,540 times wider than our Sun, and more than 280,000 times brighter. If our Sun were as bright as this star, the average temperature on Earth would be 8,000 degrees Celsius. Our oceans would boil away, and the sky would be constantly white from the overwhelming luminosity. It takes light just 15 seconds to complete a full lap of our Sun, but for WOGG64, light would take around 6 hours to do just one lap. You could fit 3.65 billion suns into WOGG64. If you replaced our Sun with this star in our solar system, it would stretch all the way out near to the orbit of Saturn. But there are objects even larger than stars in our universe. Einstein's theory of relativity predicted their existence, but they sounded just too insane to be real. So Einstein spent years trying to disprove their existence. I'm talking about the largest single objects in the entire universe. Black holes. But not just any black holes. Sure, there are stellar mass black holes with masses of just a few suns, but they're actually relatively small, around the same size as the regular planets. I want to talk about the biggest black holes in the known universe, found in the heart of most, if not all, galaxies. Supermassive black holes. These absolute monsters contain between 100,000 to tens of billions times more mass than our very own Sun. And the scary thing is, you're actually orbiting one right now. No, really. This is Sagittarius A star, the supermassive black hole at the center of our Milky Way galaxy. It weighs as much as 4.3 million suns and is 26,000 light years away from you right now. Whenever you are shown a black hole, whether it's from me or really just anyone, it's more than likely a data visualization or an artistic animation, but not this one. This is a real photograph of Sagittarius A star, one of only two black holes we have actually been able to image. The Event Horizon Telescope team used a number of radio telescopes positioned around the globe to create, essentially, a telescope the size of the Earth. This gave them enough power to zoom all the way in through the dense gas and dust of our galaxy to find Sagittarius star. And well, there it is. But the biggest supermassive black holes are almost unbelievably big. Let's start here at the size of the Sun. This first black hole, whilst being similar in size to the Sun, has more than 100,000 suns worth of mass inside of its dark abyss. As we pass out near the orbits of the inner solar system, we see other smaller supermassive black holes, before finding our very own black hole, Sagittarius A star. But this is just the beginning. As we leave the solar system, we find the real monsters of the universe. Sinus A has 2.5 billion solar masses within its depths. We pass by M87, the first black hole ever imaged, and end our journey at TON 618, the largest individual object in the known universe, confirmed by observation. Now, while that video is awesome and it does a really good job at showing you the size difference between supermassive black holes, I don't think it does that good of a job at showing you just how big TON 618 really is. Here's our solar system. The sun, planets, moons, asteroids, comets, everything humans will likely ever interact with. And this is TON 618, the largest black hole in our universe. This behemoth consumes galaxies worth of matter and is still growing to this day. Located 18 billion light years away, you could fit 11 solar systems side by side within the bounds of its event horizon, and it contains nearly 70 billion suns worth of matter. And the crazy thing is, because it's so far away, this is what it looked like 10 billion years ago. It's almost certainly much bigger today. Beyond black holes, we start to get into larger collections of stars. I'm of course talking about galaxies. You are in one right now, located around here. Our galaxy, the Milky Way, is home to 100 billion individual stars and spans around 100,000 light years wide. But how does this compare to the biggest galaxy in the universe? This is IC 1101, the biggest galaxy we know of in the universe. It contains 100 trillion individual stars and spans an insane 5.5 million light year diameter. Compared to our galaxy's 100,000 light year diameter, we are tiny. All of these objects, stars, planets, black holes, galaxies, they're all obviously, as we've shown, ridiculously large. But what's even bigger is just the universe as a whole, the space that contains all of these massive objects. The speed of light is the fastest anything can travel in our universe. It is the hard speed limit, 300 million meters per second. If you flew around the Earth at this speed, the speed of light, it would look like this, less than a blink, 0.13 seconds. Obviously, this is just insanely quick, but even traveling at this speed, it would take you 8 minutes to reach the sun, 4 years to reach the next nearest star, 2.5 million years to reach Andromeda, and 45 billion years to reach the edge of our observable universe. And of course, the universe isn't completely empty. It is filled with more galaxies than you could ever imagine. Within our observable universe, there appears to be 2 trillion individual galaxies, just like our Milky Way. And each of those 2 trillion galaxies are completely filled with hundreds of billions of its own stars, surrounded by planets just as beautiful and complex as our own. There are more planets in our universe than there are grains of sand across all the beaches and deserts on Earth. And it's not even that close. You could count 250,000 Earths worth of sand and still have more planets. And you're telling me you think we're the only planet with life on it. I can't think of many things more terrifying than the thought of us being alone in this insanely large universe.
So until next time, subscribe. Oh, it's so gross. Okay, stop.